Hi everyone, today we're going to talk about the basketball economics. Hear about basketball, what's your first thought? Jersey, basketball shoes, or... Yes, the topic is about the market of the NBA basketball players. First of all, we will start from 1989 when FIBA, the Federation Internationale de Basketball, voted to eliminate the distinction between amateurs and professionals. This ruling meant that the international players could play in the NBA without being disqualified from representing their countries in the world competitions, and thus started the flow of international players into the NBA. But due to the limited time and the lack of stats, under the condition of information asymmetry, it would make the players' salaries are not consistent with their performance. It means the salaries are higher than the players should have been after accounting for their personal characteristics and on-court performance in the previous season. The best example is Kwame Brown, and this phenomenon is called the winner's curse. The winner's curse appears when the player's value can be accounted properly. Because of excessive optimism or the lack of stats, a team will overestimate the player's value and then suffers loss. Another possible reason is when the player's value is not easy to account. If estimated correctly, the team may lose a bit, and if overestimated, the team may win a bit but also get some loss. The disappearance of the premium paid is attributed to estimate the marginal revenue product. A team can look at the performance to evaluate the players. For example, a team might look at the points scored, total rebounds and assists, and plus the experience, age, height, and etc. Further, a team might also look at how the public would embrace a given player as a predictor of his drawing power. But in this video, we will focus on the players' performance in the seasons. Divide all the players into two parts. The first, we call it the backcourt, which includes the guards and the small forward. The second is called the front line, including the power forward and the center. And then we will determine which states are the most relative with the players' salaries. In our research, we choose some of the states which are influential to the wages. There are 6 states when it comes to the backcourt and 5 states for the front line. Before we start our analysis and discussion, we first inquire of the fans which factor correlate to wages the most. For the backcourt players, top 3 are points, assists, and 3-pointer percentage. And for the frontline players, rebound, block, and free throw percentage stands out. Then, let's move on to see if the results to our research and the perspectives from the fans are identical. First of all, we'll list the top 100 players who got the highest salary during the years 2003 to 2014 individually, and we rank and classify those players by the amount of their wages, the backcourt and the front line. Next, we apply correlation coefficient to check the impact on each other. That is, we calculate the relevant level between each datum and wages by Excel and conduct a hypothesis test to clarify if there is an actual relation between wages and each datum. We'll do so by using a t-test with a confidence level of 95%. Then we can find that both states and wages are related. Lastly, we draw a proper conclusion. For the backcourt players, in the subjective viewpoint, the top 3 states which are influential to the wages are points, assists, and 3-pointer percentage. And in the objective viewpoint, points, assists, and plus-minus stands out. We can find that the 3-pointer percentage is the most different thing between the subjective and the objective data. We infer that the Golden State Warriors went viral cost 3-point field goal prevails in the NBA. For the fans, competition of 3-point field goal between the players definitely adds more excitement to the games. However, the 3-point field goal didn't prevail in the period of the data we test. For the frontline players, in the subjective viewpoint, the top 3 states which are influential to the wages are rebound, block, and free throw percentage. And in the objective viewpoint, points, plus minus, and rebound stands out. We can infer that the fans' expectation of a worth watching game, which will reflect on their anticipated performance of a player. So, they believe that the rebounds are important to the front line. However, NBA is a professional but commercial league. In order to attract more spectators to create more business opportunity, a team will take the data correlate to score into consideration primarily. After all, the win and lose of a game are a result from the point. Therefore, the objective states indicate some differences against the subjective viewpoint. Thanks for watching!